Hello everyone, my name is Vivek and I am from K4 Matrix. In this tutorial, I am going to show you how to generate T-Rex mesh for a backward facing step geometry. Now, the backward facing step is a common test case that is used for many separated flow studies, and due to its simplicity of the geometry, no database entities are required to create the mesh. I'll open pointwise. So this is the geometry that we'll be using. And I'll show you the dimensions that I have used, that is LU, LD and W/2. For that, go to the first point, press shift control and middle mouse button, and now go to the second point, shift control, middle mouse button. So you can see that the value of LU is 5 units. Similarly, 0 and 10, so that is the value of LD is 10 units. And the value of W/2 is 0.5 units. Now these values will be recorded in the messages panel as well. You can verify it later. Now before getting into the mesh, it is better if you select the solver that you will be using later. So for that, go to CAE, select solver. And you can select whichever solver you are using, and you can verify it at the left bottom corner here, SU2. Now, to create the T-Rex mesh, first we'll generate domains, that is surface mesh, then blocks, that is the volume mesh, and then we'll generate the T-Rex mesh. Now I'm going to select the connectors using shift and a selection box. So when you press shift, so the connectors that are inside the selection box are only selected. Now before this, turn off all the mask and then check only the connectors mask. Use shift, select the connectors, then select assemble blocks. So this creates both domains and blocks simultaneously. Similarly, I'll select these connectors, assemble blocks. Now to create this third block, we'll need to use this domain as well as this domain. So check the domains mask as well, then press shift and select the connectors as well as the two domains. And then select assemble blocks. So 18 domains and 3 blocks have been created. Now let's apply the boundary conditions. Go to CAE, set boundary conditions. So now I have added inlet outlet symmetry and walls. So if you want to add any new boundary conditions, you can click new and add that, and make sure that you have checked the select connections checkbox. Now I'll select this domain and I'll check this box. And so now this domain has been assigned to inlet boundary condition. I'll select this domain and I'll check this box. So now it has been assigned to outlet. I'll select these three domains. I'll check this box. So it has been assigned to the symmetry boundary conditions. Now it says that there are 11 unspecified domains. Select and click add to selection and then check walls boundary conditions. So now the remaining domains, that is the remaining 11 domains, has been assigned to walls boundary condition, and then click close. Now I'll turn off all the masks again, then I'll check the blocks mask. Now let us generate the T-Rex mesh. So first I'll select this block. I'll go to grid T-Rex, and here in the T-Rex section I'll give 500 and press enter for the maximum layers. So this maximum layers sets the maximum number of anisotropic layers you wish to have. This number does not guarantee the total number of anisotropic layers, but sets the limit on the total number of layers generated. And here make sure that you have selected the push attributes. Then go to boundary conditions. So I have added two boundary conditions here, match and wall. So now let us select the domains and assign the boundary conditions. So I'll go to list, I'll go to domains, and I'll select these two domains, and then I'll check this box. So these two domains have been assigned to match boundary condition. I've selected these three domains and I'll assign it to wall boundary condition. Click apply. Close this. Now I'll select the second block. Go to grid T-Rex. Similarly, I'll give 500 for the maximum layers. Select the push attributes. Boundary conditions. I'll select these two domains and I'll assign it to match boundary condition. And I'll select these three domains and I'll assign it to wall boundary condition. And then I'll click apply and I'll close this. I'll select the third block, go to grid T-Rex. I'll select these three domains and I'll assign it to match boundary condition. And I'll select the remaining five domains and I'll assign it to wall boundary conditions and I'll click apply. Close this. Now select all the blocks, go to grid T-Rex. So we have given all the attributes, so go to solve and then click initialize. So you can see the T-Rex mesh that is being generated here. So that's it. So that is how you generate a T-Rex mesh. Now I'll show you how to export this mesh into your solver format. So for that, select the blocks. So that is you are selecting your mesh, and then go to file, export CAE. So you can see that it will be exported to .su2 format, as I have selected my solver as su2. So this concludes today's tutorial. Stay tuned for more.